Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff does some more in-depth envelope weight editing for tuning the area around the eyes.
And while we're on these controls, there's a couple of other options for these. If you go select one of them and go to the selection for that object, you'll see this tug control parameter. And that basically determines how the strength of that orbital pull. And you can see by default it's fairly squishy. It's not a one-to-one kind of feeling on that. Depending on what you like, you might want to have that a little stronger. So, like really strong, it'd be almost, well, it is almost one-to-one. And then you'll start to see some other problems, like enveloping being too strong now. And you can go in and adjust a lot of that stuff out. And I'll show you that now, because that's a little trickier. Let's set these to 3. Okay, so that's going to be a pretty strong pull. And you start to get these pinching, and it's actually just too much deformation on the side here. So, to fix that, you go back to your Maps and Envelope Weight Paint tab. Okay, so one thing about this that's interesting is that you'll notice when you go back to your envelope painting, there are no deformers that seem to correspond to those orbital rings, and that's because there aren't. You have to go into this list and find those, and it's a little tricky. It's kind of a bit of a trick move here, but it's not too bad once you kind of know what's there. So some of this stuff may just be a simple smoothing operation to fix some of that pinching in the corners like that. But for the overactive verts out here, you basically want to get those off of those deformers, and to do that you'll have to find them. So once you know what's here, it's a little easier, and you'll know to look for these orbital deformer objects in the list. And since you can't see them, the easiest way to edit them is to use solo mode. And then you can start stepping through these and seeing what lights up, and you can adjust them that way. You can also find those deformers by doing a pick by vertex. And when you go over a vertex, it'll highlight the deformer that has the most control over that vert. So in this case, that helps you find orbital deformer 9. So if I pick that, you can start to kind of find your way around here. So these are the 5 deformers that I'm going to want to adjust for that orbital. So obviously this is the one that's having all the influence back here. So just open up your painting tab and start to pull that back out a bit. And kind of work your way down the chain a bit. And then maybe just run a nice smooth over all of that. So see that it's quite a bit better now. not perfect yet, but I'll stop there. So you can see, though, how you can start to kind of find your way around these deformers that don't have a visual counterpart in the viewport. You start kind of chasing them down by using the pick by vertex, or just by toggling through the solo modes. So we would do that on the other side as well. Still too much around the eyelid there. Okay, so none of those deformers are really causing that problem in the eyelid. So this is the perfect case for using wrinkle maps to just kind of deaden that down, because it's probably a combination of the bulging with the regions, which you can go in there and find, I'm sure, or you could just use a wrinkle map to just deaden it. Just try real quick and see what it is. So it's probably this one. So you can go in here and do it this way and pull that influence away. So that can begin to fix it. Or you could use the wrinkle map to just paint that region down so that no matter what you've got painted on it with the individual regions, the wrinkle map holds it steady. So that may be the easiest way to fix some of those kinds of problems.